This is Out of the Box with your host, Jonathan Clark. Out of the Box, Sunday nights at 9 on Q104.3.
Welcome back. Jonathan Clark here on Q104.3's Out of the Box. We are with the Tedeschi Trucks Band, or at least one percentage of them, but because it's a big band. We have Susan and Derek with us. The new album is Signs. They are on tour everywhere. All the tour dates, TedeschiTrucksBand.com. Okay, so I heard you talking about this, Susan, as I walked in. I heard the word Patriots.
Oh, gosh.
Okay, so you are a Patriots fan, are you?
No, I'm not.
You're not?
I'm from there, but my whole family is. They have plenty of fans. They don't need me.
Right, okay. So I'm a Jets fan, so you understand my pain.
Yes. I can sympathize with the
We're
Jets.
We're Jags fans, so
I understand
your pain.
Yes.
You got the former Giants general manager now.
I'm sorry we did beat you this year, but...
You beat us every year, Susan, so...
Well, you know, they were doing good at the end, though, the Jets. I mean, they were coming back a little. Yeah,
we'll see what happens this year. But we say that every year. Anyway, let's get to the new album, Signs. But first, I'm sure you've been talking about this a lot. Tell me about Kofi. Tell me an anecdote that sort of sums him up, maybe makes you laugh and think about him in a... I mean, there's so many, I'm sure, right?
We're just in that process of thinking about all of that stuff. I mean, we're 20 years on the road together. And, Kofi was just... He was just somebody that everybody loved. I mean, he was the best musician on stage, any stage he walked on. But he never made anyone feel that way. He was a sweet, sweet man. And he would go out before every show and go mingle with the audience or go to the parking lot. Like, it was just insane. Like, Kofi was
He's that guy in the band. That's great.
He was at home anywhere.
He would take a nap even for 15 minutes, like right before you go on.
10 minutes before the gig.
I have no idea how you do that.
I wanted to be that person.
Yeah,
we
all want to be that
person. I could never do that.
How can you fall asleep? Like, I mean, you know, God, it's amazing.
Yeah, we would be getting ready for the show and he'd be like, yeah, D, I'm going to go get 15 minutes.
It's like right Leonardo da Vinci.
It's
so
amazing.
Leonardo da Vinci and Kofi, I think, had something in common, which was you sleep for 15-minute naps and you never really go to sleep.
Right.
He would be up with our bus driver while he was driving all night, talking to him, keeping him awake. So I don't know. I think he was that person.
He was a resident genius. You know, he really was. I mean, and everyone recognized it. You know, everyone knew it.
Those people that can take those short naps, I really envy them, because they say if you take a nap, it shouldn't be an hour. It should be like 20 minutes.
Yeah.
Or something like that. But I can never do that. Well, listen, we're with you. Our thoughts are with you and the whole band about Kofi.
Thank you.
He is all over this new album still, correct?
I mean,
he arranged strings and he's playing keyboards. There's even
and
a flute.
I mean, Kofi, I realized yesterday I was looking at it. I've done 13 major releases with Kofi, not including live records and other things. And he's all over all of those. But this one, he's on every track, and anytime you hear any keyboard played, it's Kofi.
There's a flute solo too on one song, right? I mean,
gorgeous flute solo.
Yeah, I mean,
Strength in What Remains.
That's right. Yeah, yeah.
But the writing, the scoring, and the strings. Watching him conduct the strings, the quartet on this record was just awesome. It was so good to see him in that element, and it was just a beautiful sound he made. And he definitely went out on a high note. There's no doubt about it.
Yeah, and it's just I want to move on a second, but the album sort of encapsulates Colonel Bruce Hampton, his passing on this last song on the album called It's the Ending, right? Is that the name of that?
That's it.
And all these people that have left us to go on that, join that great rock and roll band in heaven.
Yeah, no, it's been a serious few years. We thought we were, getting out of the fog a little bit, but you keep soldiering on. Now we have, now we have somebody else to play for too. So.
Right, and get back on that horse and go back out on tour.
That's
right,
that's what we do. I know that's what he would have done. he was forward movement at all times.
Yeah,
he was the Patton of music.
The album once again recorded at your fantastic studio, Swamp Raga, and this time analog. Right, you rolled in some tape machines, a 2-inch tape?
Yeah, you know, we bought an old Studer machine a handful of years ago, but we hadn't got it fully up and running until this record, and Bobby T's was like, we need to do it. We need to record this one to tape, and They put the time and effort in to get that stuff humming, and it's an awesome sound. So it's just a better way to record.
Is it hard to find the 2-inch tape now, or you can get it, or is it coming back?
You got to search for it. There's only a few people making it, and I think I think it's overseas. The best tape is made, so you have to plan ahead. You can't run out to the store in Jacksonville and find 2-inch tape.
Right, exactly.
You got to make sure you have a supply in order before you get going.
Do you really notice a difference between digital and analog? And if so, is that like right after you record something to listen to playback, or is it maybe later while you're mixing or mastering?
Both.
Yeah,
both?
I mean, I feel like you notice it at every step of the way, especially the music that we play. It's not they're real instruments running through good old microphones, running through an old board into a tape machine. There's nothing digital happening at any point. So I think you definitely feel that warmth.
Yeah. You have some good friends on this album. Some guy named Warren, he's on this record. Also Doyle Bramhall II, too. What song is he on?
Doyle's on
I'm Gonna Be There.
And okay. All the World.
And All the World is Bleeding.
And a tune that we wrote and recorded that we'll release it somewhere else called High and Mighty. But we wrote three tunes with Doyle, and he tracked all of those. And then Warren came in. We had finished this tune. It was instrumental at the time, and I could tell he heard something, and I asked him if he wanted to take the tune with him, and he wrote the lyrics and the melody, vocal melody to Walk Through This Life. So that was a lot of fun. And then we have his voice on there, too, so he's singing in the... singing in the choir with us.
Yeah. This tour brings you, God, everywhere. I was looking at the tour dates. Across America, Europe, Asia, like nonstop. You guys have two teenagers now.
Yeah.
So what happens? Do they go to school like during the year, and then on summer, do they go out on the road with you guys? Or
yeah. No, they're out all summer with us. Until about 2 years ago, they were pumped to come out with us in the summertime, but now they have agendas that we have to drag them along.
Well, our son has got a girlfriend.
Yeah.
Wait,
how old is he?
16. He'll be 17 next month.
Okay. All right.
And he is just made National Honor Society. He doesn't like to miss school. He's a very dedicated, student as well as boyfriend and baseball player. So he doesn't want to let anybody down.
Right.
Whether it's a coach or a girlfriend or a parent.
He works hard.
Or a teacher.
But we make him come out on the road anyways.
Yeah, we make him come out and corrupt him. But he's a good kid. And, you know, we're really lucky to have both of our kids are amazing. And they're both so sweet to put up with our lifestyles.
Yeah.
You know, they both really have been amazing.
I'm thinking they might be the coolest kids in their schools, though, right? I mean, there's got to be a little of that.
You know, they're pretty subtle about everything. they keep a lot of this stuff close to the vest, which I appreciate. We have to drag things out of them. Like when our son made National Honor Society, he didn't tell any of us. He was looking for clothes for
the ceremony. He called me like, Mom, where are my khaki pants?
You
got to
tell us about this stuff, man.
I need my pants.
Well, I mean, you know, I'm sure you got it. I know that I got it. Most guys get it, and girls. So what does your dad do? What does your mom do? You know, I can imagine that conversation. Or are they just sort of like
they're like, they're musicians.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Right.
No, we're going to take them to Japan this year. We're excited for that because they went.
Oh, my God.
When I did the tour with Clapton way back, 06, 07, we brought them over then. They were small then, so it'll be nice to get them over.
They were 2 and 4.
Yeah.
Wow.
Sophia was born in 2004.
That's a great place for a 2 and 4-year-old, though, because there's
a lot of
blinking lights and just odd things.
Boy, 2 and 4, time flies, doesn't it?
That's for sure. That's for sure.
While you're having fun. We're with the Tedeschi Trucks Band. The new album is Signs. They're on tour everywhere. All the tour dates, TedeschiTrucksBand.com. Will you be doing the extended Beacon Run again in October?
Absolutely.
Okay, good.
I think we're going to set up shop there as long as they'll have us. So it's our second home without a doubt.
Yeah.
The Beacon feels like home. Going back to talking about our kids, when Charlie was 7 days old, Sue drove up with my brother and his wife and our seven-day-old son and was at the Beacon.
From
he had been
New
in
York.
That. Yeah.
That's a road trip right there.
But he's been in those dressing rooms every year in March up until we stopped doing the Beacon Run with the Almonds, and now every year now, so it's home for us.
Stairs backstage at the Beacon are a little tricky for little kids, I would think.
Oh yeah, we put him on the elevator.
Well, he was a baby. I mean, he was an infant, and it was actually right after 9/11, so I was a little concerned about the air quality.
Oh, yeah.
So we stayed on the Upper East Side and kind of stayed close to the hotel and then would visit, you know, the Beacon Theater a little bit.
Yeah.
But we didn't travel too much after that.
You guys are going to play a live song for us off the new album. This is the song I've actually been playing on the show. It's a song called Hard Case. What can you tell us about this song?
This is a tune Mike Madison brought in, one of the principal songwriters in this band, and then back to my solo group. Mike's an amazing songwriter, and whenever we make a record, he always has two or three ideas that he's been that have just been brewing for a while. And this is one. When we did the Mad Dogs and Englishmen tour, or the tribute show with Leon Russell and that whole crew,
the
band
that.
Really kind of it kind of snapped into a new place. It started owning that sound and that feel, and realizing that that's a place we can go. And I think this is an idea that came from that experience, you know, thinking about Delaney and Bonnie and all of that music, and you know, the co-lead vocals with Susan and Mark and Susan and Mike, and it's just a great tune. As soon as we started messing with it in the studio, we're like, this is our wheelhouse.
Yeah.
this is fun to play, and it's fun to hear them sing it.
Absolutely. Tedeschi Trucks Band, the new album, Signs. They're on tour everywhere. All the tour dates, TedeschiTrucksBand.com. We'll look for them at the Beacon Theater this coming October. Derek and Susan, thank you guys so much.
Yeah, man. Thank you.
Best of luck, and we'll see you back at the Beacon.
Absolutely.
This is Out of the Box with your host, Jonathan Clark. Out of the Box, Sunday nights at 9 on Q104.3.